ceramics. This versatile material has not only firmly established itself in our everyday lives, but has also proven to be extremely useful in many different areas, continuing to be as contemporary as ever before. It may take center stage, or perhaps it works inconspicuously in the background without us noticing it. Irrespective of where, how, and when, ceramic materials have always been adapted to the current needs of mankind and been continuously improved. Today, we are able to employ this valuable resource in more diverse and flexible ways than ever before. Let us take a closer look. The ingredients for ceramic materials are simple. Take the elements earth, water, air, and fire. A recipe that has proven itself throughout the ages and which, thanks to its natural origins, is as modern today as it has ever been. Before it can be turned into actual ceramic, the earth has to be ground and mixed with other natural materials before being given the desired shape. This might take the form of refractories, technical ceramics, fine ceramics, or heavy clay. But this is only one among many ways of classifying the endless range of possible materials. After being shaped, the ceramic products are placed in a dryer to remove most of the moisture. The material is then inserted into a kiln, where it is fired for several hours, after which it is ready for use. But what makes this simple building material so sophisticated and versatile? The answer is pretty simple. Physics. Clay bricks are able to withstand the temperature fluctuations of their surroundings. Take cold, for example. On its way through the brick, it is constantly weakened, just like heat. The secret lies not only in the large chambers, but also in the brick's many fine pores and arteries that distort or help to retain the temperature. Furthermore, the brick is able to absorb moisture and release it back to the surrounding air as soon as humidity drops. This way, the inside of a house stays dry and air-conditioned in the most natural of ways. Or take fire, for instance. Since the bricks have already been fired, they can withstand the flames of a fire for a long time. But these are only a few examples showing how versatile ceramic is. A house consists of so much more than just plain bricks, pipings, ceiling blocks, hollow bricks, facing bricks, roof tiles, floor tiles, clay pavers. Nowadays, there are almost no limits as to the number of ceramic materials that can be produced. Here, you won't find damp walls, or high heating, or air conditioning bills. And besides saving money, you also help to protect the environment. The sustainable way these buildings have been constructed means they can survive for a long time, creating a safe and comfortable home even for your grandchildren.
Ceramics have been produced by mankind for thousands of years, and they are still made using completely natural material. Today, ceramic companies still create jobs in their vicinity, even though the production process has become more and more automated. This holds true not only in the Netherlands, but all around the world. And this is a great development because it preserves natural resources and doesn't harm the environment. For instance, the residual heat from the kilns is transferred directly to the dryers, saving energy. Clay extraction is, compared to other building materials, quite challenging, because in most countries, clay mining companies are required to recultivate the mining areas. This means giving nature time to reclaim the area and to let animals find their way back into it. Wherever you look, you won't find another construction material that is so durable and yet so gentle on the environment. Here at our independent institute in Arnhem-Velp, we are developing innovative products that meet the highest of standards. We check the composition of the clay, its reaction to firing, drying, to cold and to heat, to water, and also whether the products can endure high forces. Through our tests, we have numerous ways of guaranteeing that our customers have a building material that is both 100% natural and safe.
Mi chiamo Benedetta Tagliabue.
My name is Benedetta Tagliabue. I'm an Italian who has lived in Barcelona for 22 years. I'm a Barcelonese Italian. We do projects all over the world, in Spain, Edinburgh, the Netherlands, and Germany. We recently opened a branch in Shanghai, where we began with the design of the Spanish Pavilion for the World Expo 2010.
Ma noi amiamo tantissimo I materiali.
We love working with ceramic materials and bricks, so much so that we have used them in almost all of our buildings. I believe they are a traditional material, very beautiful, long-lasting, ecological, and you can use them in many different ways.
Si possono usare anche in maniere molto diverse. Io credo che Santa Caterina veramente ha aiutato molto a fare che gli architetti accettassero.
I think that Santa Caterina was a real breakthrough for the renewed acceptance of decorative ceramics by architects. We like to use bricks in public buildings. This is because, although it is a discrete material, when displayed in public buildings, it has proven to be so sophisticated that it has become an extremely representative element.
Poter diventare un elemento molto rappresentativo. Non lo so, mi piacerebbe forse sapere anche di più.
I don't know. I would like to find out more about heavy clay from a scientific point of view. We architects intuitively consider brick to be a warm material that we like to keep close to us. It is a natural material with tradition and an extremely beautiful one. It is also a material that makes building in cost-effective ways possible.
È un materiale bellissimo, poi che si trasforma, non ha soltanto l'applicazione.
It comes in many different shapes, covering a lot of surfaces, not just hidden behind the wall. It covers the floor, the walls, all kinds of surfaces.
My name is Lode Waas. I'm administrator of the company Van Harens. We are a building company and a constructing company and a developer. We are at the military hospital in Antwerp. It's a project of 8 hectares where we will construct about 420 different houses, apartments and lofts in total. It's very important that the architect has chosen bricks. Because this makes the homogeneity between the old buildings and the new buildings. It is a very good product for the sustainability. The nicest example is we hear the noise of cleaning, the cleaning of the bricks, because we reuse the old bricks from 200 years ago.
We see in the different projects we are doing that more and more architects, even for modern projects, choose clay products, which we are very fond of, like in our recent projects, we almost worked only with clay products. We start to use now clay pavers also. We have clay bricks and clay roof tiles, inner walls and clay. Like here in those old buildings, we use inner wall blocks to make a distinction between the two houses because of the acoustic characteristics of the material and also the insulation value and the inert material. This project is a nice example of a mixture of social houses, affordable houses and upwarded houses. And the bricks play the role as an equalizer. So bricks can be used for the different classes in the society as a building material. And as a result, you hardly see the difference between a social house, an upwarded house or an affordable house here in the project of the military hospital in Antwerp.
For thousands of years, ceramic products have helped us to improve our lives. No matter where you are in this world or how you live. We help people to pursue this path and to use this valuable material to provide sustainable answers to some of the most pressing questions of our time.